Parents or your relatives. The talk will be delivered by Sheikh Imran Kudi, a graduate of Darul Al-Arabiya Al-Islamiyya from Cape Town, sitting for his Master's of Clinical Psychology at the University of South Africa. JazakAllah.
اللهم أخرجنا من ظلمات الوهم وأكرمنا بنور الفهم وفتح علينا بمعرفة العلم وسهل أخلاقنا بالحلم واجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنا. اللهم اجعل أعمالنا خالصة لوجهك ولا تجعل في أحد غير. وصل اللهم على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن وسلم على بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, we praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His infinite mercy, who has accepted us once again to be in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this day of Jumu'ah. Really, this is the best day of the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for granting us this opportunity to be present here among us. Respected elders, brothers, and all those that are tuning in, today's topic we're going to be reflecting on the importance of speaking up against injustice and being truthful and fair in your conduct. And it is such an apt topic because we are known as the Ummatul Haq, we are known as the nation of truth, we are known as Ahlul Haq, we are known as the people of truth, and mashallah, today we find ourselves in Masjidul Haq, the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where the truth is. So we're going to take some time to reflect on the importance of speaking against injustice and also some ways and methodology that we can apply so that we can acquire this quality of speaking up against injustice. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talking about this in the Quran, says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا كونوا قوامين بالقسط شهداء لله ولو على أنفسكم أو الوالدين والأقربين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, referring to the believers, O you who believe, be firm upon speaking the truth as a witness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنْفُسِكُمْ, even it is upon yourself, or towards your parents, or even to your close relatives. Then the verse continues, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِيَّكُمْ غَنِيًّا أَوْ فَقِيرًا اللَّهُ أَوْلَىٰ بِهِمَا. Even if you're speaking against those who are richer than you or poorer than you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more right about them. فَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا الْهَوَىٰ أَن تَعْدِلُوا. So don't follow your desires and let it come in the way of you speaking the truth. وَإِن تَلْهُوا أَوْ تُعْرِدُوا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرًا. For if you do not speak the truth and you withhold speaking the truth, then verily know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of that which you are doing. So let us take a few moments to reflect on the specificity of this verse of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we need to be firm and resolute in speaking the truth, وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَنْفُسِكُمْ, even if it is against our own selves. And this reminds us of a beautiful incident in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If we look into his seerah, we find that there was an occasion in which a sahabiyya, a female companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to inform him that, O Prophet of Allah, I have indeed committed adultery. I have indeed committed adultery And O Prophet of Allah, you should purify me. You should carry out the hudud, the penal punishment for committing adultery. And as we know, the penal punishment for committing adultery is stoning. So the Sahabiyya out of her own self came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to inform him that, O Prophet of Allah, I have indeed committed adultery. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam found this very difficult to accept. And he turned away sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she came again to him and informed that, O Prophet of Allah, I have indeed committed adultery. To which he replied that, O Sahabiyya, O Fulana, go back and give birth to the child first. Go back and give birth to the child first. Then the Sahabiyya, the female companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she gave birth to the child and came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, presenting the child in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To which he again replied, O Sahabiyya, my female companion, go back and feed the child, breastfeed the child until the child reaches a state of maturity. A time passed, my beloved brothers, and she came back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the child reaching a level of maturity that now he can, he's fine. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the child and gave the child over to the responsibility of the other companions. And at that time, he ordered that the whole should be taken and that she should be stoned. On this occasion, Khalid bin Walid, Sayyidullah, the Sword of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he threw the stone, some of the blood gushed on Khalid bin Walid. And when the blood came on him, he rebuked this. And he said something very nasty towards the lady. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard Khalid say these words. To which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rebuked Khalid and said, Oh Khalid, if you only knew the type of tawbah that this lady made, repenting towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaks about her tawbah and the acceptance of her tawbah, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala definitely forgave her. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then buried her and performed firstly a salatul janazah and then buried her. So what do we learn from this incident, my beloved brothers? Firstly, we learn the importance of speaking against injustice, even if it's against yourself. If you know you have done something wrong, then it is best to admit it. When I was reading on the tafsir of this specific verse of the Quran, Ibn Kathir mentions that the Prophet says that the best testimony that you can give is a testimony that you give before even being asked about it. So that's the best testimony that you can give. So we see in the examples of the companions of the Prophet they desire to uphold the truth and speak the truth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. The second lesson that we can also learn from this incident is how difficult it is to carry out justice. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carried out the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he had a heavy heart because he knew it was something difficult. So we learn that carrying out justice is also something that is difficult. But we should always put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. Because when we are carrying out justice and we're doing things, we are doing it not for our own sake, but for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. The verse then goes on further and says, أَوِ الْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ, that you should speak up against injustice, even if it is your parents, أَوِ الْأَقْرَبِينَ, your close siblings. It's as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows and understands the fitrah of insan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how difficult it is to speak up against our parents. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows how difficult it is to speak up against our siblings if they do wrong. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that even though you have love for them, even though you have compassion for them, it shouldn't prevent you from speaking the truth and being fair and being just. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places great importance on treating your parents with kindness, but that shouldn't come in the way of you speaking the truth if they have done something wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. It reminds us of another incident. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a Bedouin. And this Bedouin came towards Makkah with the intention of selling his camels. And on his way, he came across Abu Jahl. And we know that Abu Jahl was a staunch enemy of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he struck a deal with Abu Jahl, saying that I will sell you my camels, and in return that you have to pay me a certain amount. Abu Jahl agreed to this, and he took the camels and he said, later I will pay you. However, when the individual went to Abu Jahl, Abu Jahl refused to pay this individual what he owed him. And this individual, this Bedouin, with a heavy heart, he turned away and went towards the Kaaba. And he asked the individuals, is there anyone that can assist me in this situation? And nobody wanted to assist the Bedouin. Until a group of individuals said that, oh, you go to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he will assist you. But the intention was that if they should go to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would know that Abu Jahl will mock the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and perhaps hurt the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his desire for justice and his desire to speak up for those who are weak and are in a difficult situation, he went with his Bedouin to the house of Abu Jahl, knocked on the door of Abu Jahl and instructed Abu Jahl to come out. Abu Jahl eventually comes out and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives him the instruction that, oh Abu Jahl, you have an agreement with this individual, please pay him the money that you owe him. To which Abu Jahl surprisingly obliged to the order of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Later, it is reported that Abu Jahl, he said that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam instructed him to come out, he saw behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a huge camel, and he feared that the camel would consume him, and as a result, he obliged the order of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we see this, my beloved brothers, the importance, what we learn from this, is the importance of speaking up to injustice. Even if we fear the individual, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect us in that situation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. And then I will just end off, my beloved brothers, on perhaps two ways in which we can acquire this quality of speaking up against injustice. The first way we can acquire this quality is to firstly adapt the quality of taqwa. We firstly need to strive for taqwa, for Allah consciousness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلْتَقْوَى. Be just, for it is the closest thing to taqwa. So we see the connection between being just and taqwa. So if we strive to acquire the quality of taqwa, we will automatically become just in our dealings with individuals. And the first step to acquiring taqwa is we need to strive to perform our 5 daily salahs in taqwa. That is one of the easiest ways towards acquiring taqwa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. Then the second way we can develop this quality is that we need to start with the small things. Be consistent on small things. For example, an individual goes to the shop and the shopkeeper gives him some extra change, 10 cents, 20 cents, 50 cents over. You have to have that quality of being just and fair and return that which is not yours. In the small things, if we develop the small qualities, my beloved brothers, eventually we will be able to develop the greater and bigger qualities, my beloved brothers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. And with that, my beloved brothers, we come to an end. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our lives. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the quality of taqwa. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to speak up against those who do injustice. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the desire that we should be just, even if it is against ourselves. Wa ma tawfiqi illa billah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول
فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، واشهد ان لا اله الا الله الحديث في الخطبة الأولى عن القسط في القرآن، وقد سمعنا الآيات التي ذكرها الله في القسط. وفي هذه الخطبة نتحدث عن القسط في السنة النبوية، ويخبر رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم أن الأرض إذا امتلأت بالجود والذل قيض الله لها من يملأ بالقسط والعدل، وهذا من أعظم المبشرات لنا في هذا الزمان الذي غاب فيه القسط وقل فيه العدل. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: لو لم يبق من الدنيا إلا يوم لطور الله ذلك اليوم، ثم اتفقوا حتى يبعث فيه رجلا مني أو من أهل بيتي يواضي اسمه اسمي واسم أبيه اسم أبي، يملأ الأرض قسطا وعدلا كما ملئت ظلما وجورا. صلوا وسلموا وأكثروا من الصلاة والسلام على من أمركم ربكم بالصلاة والسلام عليه. فقال عز من قائل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا القسط في أقوالنا وأفعالنا، اللهم اجعلنا من المقسطين، اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه يا رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله.